so much. Welcome once again, ladies and gentlemen, to another exciting edition of 321, the show that asks questions, features rejections, and demands perception. Now, we pout and pound some prizes. Nobody leaves here empty-handed, of course. We've got our usual team with us, so we've got our regular guests. We also have some surprise guests for you. And there's one little character, well, he's just the wealth hazard, no matter which way you look at it, because anybody could lose if they win this fella. You know who I'm talking about, don't you? Who is it? Yeah. Dusty Bin. Got it in one go. Here he is with Karen Palmer. Okay, you've got me now, Karen. What theme does Dusty represent this week?
Well, he's dressed as a tourist. And anyway, we're going to have lots of fun this week because it's holidays abroad.
Ah, the theme is holidays abroad. That means that in part two, we'll be sort of reflecting those marvellous sunny days we all spent lazing on the continent. Right now, we're going to meet the people, of course, with the first-class tickets. The most important people, as always on our programme, our contestants. Greet them, please.
From Swift Cottage, Peter and Teddy Joy Babar. From Torrington, here are Arthur and Carrie Leff. From home, please welcome Stuart and Elaine McGregor.
Right, OK, ladies and gentlemen, as you know, we always start with our quiz. Three couples in the quiz. At the end of that, we'll have two couples left playing our elimination game to see which couple, the one couple, going through to the big prizes tonight. Let's meet the first couple tonight. It's Elaine and Stuart McGregor.
That's right.
Yes, and you're from Hove. Hove, of course, in Sussex.
That's right.
Near lovely Brighton. And what do you do then, Stuart, for a living? What do you do?
Well, we have a business. We make cakes for people, and we also teach others how to decorate cakes.
And he says here that you've got a sort of a little present for us, or Dusty or something.
Yes, that's right. We thought that since you're giving Dusty bins to everybody else, we'd give a cake to you in the show.
Right. Very lovely, huh? Here we are. That's nice. There you go. It's nearly the real thing. That's beautiful.
It is.
Did that take long to make that?
It took a certain amount of time.
I'm sure it is.
Yes.
Beautiful. Oh, well, I'm sure we're going to have a great time munching on that. Thank you very much for bringing that along. Mate, I know, actually, he asked for a cake to be made with a file in it. It was for a prisoner who likes to have his cake and beat it.
Yeah.
Now then, Elaine, it says here that how long have you, in fact, lived here? You lived for a while in Australia, yes?
Yes. My parents immigrated when I was five, so I was brought up in Australia.
So, in fact, are you Australian?
No, I'm English.
You are English, but you've still got that lovely accent there. Which part of Australia were you?
Sydney, and we lived in Melbourne and Adelaide,
yes,
as well.
Yeah, I've been to Sydney. I know. Do you know Double Bay in Sydney?
Yes.
Yeah, I stayed there. Because you said they have... It's similar. When you think of it, you have Hove near Brighton, they have a nude beach, and they've also got one in Sydney, haven't they?
Yes.
And the nude beach in Sydney has proved to be a great shark deterrent. Because now the sharks can actually see what they're getting. They no longer want it. However, we have children, don't you?
Yes, we have two. A boy, Christopher, who's 8,
yes,
and Fiona, who's 6.
Oh, that's nice. OK, let's get on then and have your questions. We've got Libby Roberts with your questions. Libby? OK. Now then, Libs. Hey, Libs, you went to a health farm this week, yes?
Yes, that's right, Ted, but there's some very strange fruit machines there.
How do you mean, strange fruit machines?
Well, you put your money in, and if three coins come up in a row, you win 100 oranges.
Well, at least it's something, isn't it? Would you like to select your questions, please?
Thank you. We'll take the middle ones.
OK, the middle ones are going to take... Would you like to take that lovely Dusty? That's it. Don't eat it without me, will you?
Don't drop it.
That's it. Don't drop it. It's a very heavy one, too. Thank you. OK, Stuart and Elaine, you know what happens. We do like you to answer alternately, of course. And there's a couple of ways you can be stopped. If you make a mistake or if you give us the wrong answer, of course, you run out of time. And we always let you have one to start with here. You play for £10 each correct answer. Now, this question is about tourist attractions in various countries of the world. We will give you the objects of interest, and we want you to say which country they can be found in. Remember, it's the country we want, not cities, the country. Now, we'll start you with the Taj Mahal, which is in India. So the Taj Mahal is...
India.
Table Mountain.
Don't know.
Arc de Triomphe.
France.
Acropolis.
Greece.
Pyramids.
Egypt.
Mount Fuji.
Japan.
Sugarloaf Mountain.
Brazil.
Gondolas.
Venice.
Venice is in Italy, but of course we did in fact want the country there. So that one is wrong. Table Mountain, in fact, you didn't know that. South Africa. But you've not done bad at all. You got 6, so that's £60.
£60 they have.
Nice. Very nice. Lovely. Wow. Wow. Here we have Peter. Peter Babani. Babani. Yes, I got that right, Peter. Yeah, Babani. And Hedy Joy Babani.
Yes.
And you're from London. Hedy Joy, that's a name, huh? Hedy Joy.
Yes, yes. My mother loved film stars.
Yes.
And I suppose I'm very lucky she didn't call me after Walter Pigeon. Could happen, you know. You don't know my mother.
Peter, what do you do for a living?
I'm a publisher of children's books.
I see. Anything special? What sort of books do you
sell? Christmas annuals, based on the Muppets and the Hulk. Lots of the Incredible characters. Hulk? Yeah. Spider-Man.
Your Spider-Man, yeah. I love the Incredible Hulk, yeah. He always gets so angry, isn't he?
Yeah.
It's all the Green Cross Man, really, isn't it? So we... Oh, just a few groans, Peter. Yeah. We're not as bad as we thought. OK, let's have your questions. Alison Temple Savage has a question. Alison, the theme this week is holidays abroad. Now, you've travelled quite a bit, haven't you? What sort of places have you been to?
Oh, Edward, all sorts of mad places. But once I booked up for 7 nights in the land of the Eskimo.
Oh, how'd you get on?
Well, I was away 3.5 years.
Yeah, I didn't think that'd work either. But don't worry too much about it. Select your questions, Peter. Eddie Joy, would you like to?
This one.
Lovely. Okay, thanks very much, Alison. Okay, now then, same thing. £10 each correct answer. If you don't know an answer, just say don't know. I'll carry on with the next question. The one we let you have to start with, don't forget that. This question is about souvenirs which people bring back from foreign holidays. We will give you the object and we want you to say which country it is most likely to come from. Now, nesting dolls come from Russia. Okay, the ones that sort of slot inside each other. So that's the one we'll start you with. Nesting dolls come from?
Russia.
Castanets come from?
Spain.
Lederhosen.
Germany.
Clogs.
Holland.
Boomerang.
Australia.
Bottle of champagne.
France.
Kimono.
Japan.
Kilt.
Scotland.
Shillelagh.
Ireland.
Bottle of port.
Portugal.
Good, you got a maximum, £100. Oh. That's good. Okay. Here we go. This is Carol and Arthur Lett, and you're from Torrington.
Torrington.
Torrington, which is North Devon. Now, Arthur, you see, you're a well-travelled man. It says you were born in Venezuela.
Correct.
Yes.
Yes.
You then went to Antigua.
Yes.
Did I say that right? Is it
correct? Antigua.
Antigua. Well, you met Carol when you were over here from Antigua on holiday. Yes. And what sort of business are you in?
I'm in the news agency.
News agency.
News agency.
I see. So you're used to sort of standing behind the counter.
Correct. Yes.
So shall I move over here with the questions? You can read them upside down.
Well, I don't mind watching it.
Lovely. And okay, what do we have? Carol, do you assist in the news agency as well?
No, I don't. No, I work in a travel agency.
Travel agency?
Yes, that's right.
Oh, we have a few in,
support.
Do we? Support. Because I travel quite a bit by car. I'd go by rail a lot more if I could be sure I wasn't going to bump into Jimmy Savile. It'll do a switch. Let's have your questions. Fiona Curzon has them. Fiona. Ah. Well, believe this. Fiona, this is true. You had some sort of a win this week on the pools, didn't you?
Yes, Ted, I did.
How do I stand for a loan?
You don't stand, you beg.
As always, let's have their questions. Thank you, Harry. Smashing. Okay, now, same procedure, £10 each correct answer. We'll let you have one to start with. Don't know an answer, say don't know. The question is about symbols, both official and unofficial, of various countries. We will give you the symbol and we want you to give us the country. Now, we'll start you with the rose, the symbol of England. So, the rose and...
England.
The thistle.
Don't know.
Windmill.
Holland.
The maple leaf.
Canada.
The kiwi.
New Zealand.
The daffodil.
Don't know.
Springbok.
South Africa.
Kangaroo.
Don't know.
Shamrock.
Ireland.
And the bear.
Russia.
Right, OK. At the end of that lot, there was two you didn't know. The daffodil is the symbol of Wales. Got me. I thought it was the leek. The thistle is the symbol of Scotland, but that's right. No, there's one more. Yes, that is one there. Kangaroo, you didn't know, was Australia. You've got seven, so that's £70 you have. Well done. Classic. OK, here we are. So, Elaine and Stuart are here on £60. Libby here with your second round questions.
Get
would you like to select
again.
Them? Okay. Second one again. Thanks, Libby. OK. Good luck to you. Don't forget, we still give you one to start with in this round. This question is about national airlines of various countries. We will give you the name of the airline, and we want you to give us the country. Now, KLM is the airline of Holland, Netherlands. So KLM and?
Holland.
El Al is the airline of?
Israel.
Alitalia.
Italy.
Aer Lingus.
Ireland.
Qantas.
Australia.
Sabena.
Belgium.
Lufthansa.
Don't know.
Aeroflot.
Russia.
TAP.
Don't know.
Varig, Varig. V-A-R-I-G, Varig.
Sweden.
No, wrong. Not a, you had a good stab in the dark. It was Brazil. TAP was Portugal, Lufthansa was Germany. Not bad, though. What have you got right there? At the end of that round, what are they scoring, folks, back there? £420. Well done. Thank you very much. This time, Hedy Joy and Peter are going for £100 each correct answer. This question is about countries and the main languages of that country. Spoken. We will give you the country, and we want you to give us the main language of the country, OK? Now then, would you believe, the main language of Greenland is Danish. So that's the one we'll start you with. The main language of Greenland is...
Danish.
The main language of Mexico.
Spanish.
Main language of Brazil.
Portuguese.
South Africa.
Afrikaans.
Austria.
Don't know.
Israel.
Hebrew.
Algeria.
French.
Iran.
Farsi.
Taiwan.
Chinese.
Canada.
English.
Right, there you go. You've done pretty well again. One you didn't know. One you didn't know there. That was number five. Austria, in fact, was German. It looks like you have, yes, you got nine. £900. Oh, fantastic. That's it. Okay, there you are. Carol and Arthur. This time they're playing for £70 for each correct answer. Nice high scoring tonight. This question is about rulers of various countries. We will give you the ruler, and we want you to give us the country they ruled. Now, we'll start you with Napoleon, who ruled France. So, Napoleon ruled...
France.
Mao Zedong.
China.
General Perón. Perón.
Pass.
Mussolini.
Pass.
Idi Amin.
Uganda.
Mr. Nehru.
India.
Calvin Coolidge.
Pass.
Queen Juliana.
Holland.
Kwame Nkrumah.
Pass.
And General Franco?
Spain.
We're right out on Spain, I'm afraid. They just pipped us to that. General Franco, you were right, Arthur. It was, in fact, Spain. My Kwame Nkrumah was Ghana. Calvin Coolidge was the United States, and Perón, General Perón, was Argentina. So at the end of that round, what have we got? You've got £350. Well done. Oh, well, this is unbelievable. We've got couple number three, Carol and Arthur, on £350. We've got Elaine and Stuart up there, couple number one, £420. The winners this week, and it's the second time anyone's got this high, Hedy Joy and Peter, £900. Smashing. Well, Arthur and Carol, I don't know how to say goodbye to you with just £350. People have not won with that amount of money, I can tell you that. It's always so sort of a shame to say goodbye to anybody at this sort of stage of the game, but it's not bad. You have. It's been great having you with us. Well, there's your money. Take that, Arthur. You hold it, darling. I love that. Gives it to the wife.
Thank you.
There's your ceramic dusty worth a little more. Thanks a lot for coming, Carol. Take care. Give them a round of applause. Congratulations. Right. Okay. Right, we're back with our remaining couples to play the 3-2-1 video elimination game in part two. See ya, 3-2-1. Don't go too far now. Whoa! Part two of 3-2-1. We're about to play our video elimination game. We've got Hedy Joy and Peter Babani from London, and we've got Elaine and Stuart from Hove in Sussex about to play. They've got through with marvellous money this week. What have you got? 300? 420, yeah, and you've only got 900. That's not bad. That's already yours, you know that. At the bottom of the screen, you can see you've got a bat which can be moved from left to right by using the control stick. Object is to hit the ball against the wall. Every time you hit the wall at the top of the screen, you'll score points. If you do get lucky enough to chip your way through the wall, believe me, the score will rattle along, build up a lot of points, and you'll win. Naturally, the couple with the most amount of points will go through with a chance to take home a great prize tonight. Every time you miss the ball, however, you must change the places with a partner, give the control stick to whoever is playing with you. Who's playing first out of you two?
I am.
Peter's playing first. Thank you. Good luck. And, OK, Stuart, who's playing first here? You are Elaine. Peter as well. Good. Yeah. Okay, you know we have the red light here in the middle, which will start to flash. When it does that, you know you're on the last few seconds of the game. So good luck to all of you. Here we go now. 3, 2, 1, away we go. Seconds of the game. Okay, we're out of time right there. Would you like to hold it? Okay, Peter, Stuart, thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Now, let's see how well we've done then. Well, at the end of that, we got Elaine and Stuart have scored 21, but Hedy Joy and Peter have scored 35, they have. Well done. Yeah. Oh, dear. Well. There you go again, 900 quid you already have and you've won through. That means you've got a chance to take home a great prize tonight. Of course, we do have to say goodbye to Elaine and Stuart right now, but here's the money you won, which was what?
Oh, 420 pounds.
Only 420 pounds. There's your ceramic dustbin. There's another photo frame. And of course, your 3-2-1 video game. Thank you very much, Stuart. You can't shake hands, but thanks a lot for coming. Thanks again for the cake. Very sweet of you. Bye, Elaine.
Bye-bye.
See you down there in Hope sometime. Give them a round of applause, folks. Lovely couple. Smashing. Yeah. Okay, Peter and Hedy Joy, that means... Well, you know what goes on here, of course. Yeah. We've got 5 items to show you, and we've got 5 prizes, 4 terrific ones, and that booby dusty bin. Remember, you win him, that's all you get. Just the dustbin, that's all you get. But nevertheless, at the end of each of our little scenes, one character will leave you a clue object, read you a rhyme. When you have 3 of them on my table, Ted's table, I'll ask you to reject one. When you've rejected 4 of them, the one that remains will tell you just what prize you're going to take back with you tonight. So as we said at the top of the show, the theme this week is holidays abroad, and the offering here deals with something that happens before you go away, the planning of your vacation. And the person you're to go to for advice, of course, the travel agent.
Yes, yes, I see, yes, that's 2 weeks, a double room, and no press men. Yes, of course, Your Royal Highness, yes, a pleasure. Goodbye.
A cringe of the clunge, a labour in labour.
Getting tagging mine here, senor. Viva l'Espagne, ole. Shemmy doofer, and half a bottle of Beaujolais.
I beg your pardon. You learned all that from a record, you know. Proper little linguist, aren't we?
No, I'm a Catholic. Listen to this. This is really fluent now. Bonjour, mesdames and messieurs. God save all here. Des wish, des jewel, les messieurs. Shut up, I'm talking.
You're English. I'm sure they'd never guess. How can I help you, sir?
Well, I'd like to book a holiday. Somewhere exoticable.
Abroad?
You can fix those up as well, can you?
No, I meant overseas.
Oh, no, not overseas. Somewhere foreign. Pity to waste the money on the record, you see?
Yes, yes, of course, yes. Maybe you have something particular in mind.
Oh, you bet I've got something particular in mind. Some place with lots of sea, lots of sand, lots of sun, and... plenty of birds, you know what I mean? The little birds.
Yes, I think I know what you have in mind.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see now. Lots of sun,
sea,
and sand.
And sand. Yeah. And don't forget the birds.
I'm not forgetting the birds.
Not forgetting the birds.
Yes, I've got just the place for you, sir.
Oh, yes, what's it called?
There it is.
Puffin Island!
Now, Puffin Island, Christopher and Michael. This is Hedy Joy and Peter Babani.
How are you going?
Going through with a bit of a chance to take home a good prize, we hope, tonight. That's why we're here. We've decided not to go to the table. We've come to the travel office. What are you going to leave as the clue?
Perfect place to come. Right.
Perfect place.
Mike's going to read the rhyme. I'll give you the clue. The clue is a map.
Right. Okay? And the words are, keep this at home or toe the line. You may do one or the other. But as this rhyme unfolds, you may home in on another.
What do you reckon, Pete? Any idea?
Home in on another.
Uh-huh.
Homing pigeon.
Well, we might give you more than
fly
a pigeon.
Somewhere.
Well, there you go. Good. You're thinking about it straight away. Tell you what, don't forget, we have three on the table, then you have to reject one. Let's get on now and have our next item, because when holidaying abroad these days, they really are for sunbathing and swimming, but the nights are for visiting the clubs to take in the cabaret. And one kind of act is international. That's magic. And when it's combined with comedy, it just can't miss. Judge for yourself as we greet the great Soprendo.
Muy bien, señorita. Aquí tengo una taza de té hecho de las aguas fresquitas de los ríos bellísimos de España la Gloriosa. It means I got your cup of tea.
Oh, tar.
Oh, I thought you want a cup of tar. Did I get a little tip? Little tip? No tip. Okay. She's the original tea bag. I tell you what I do to get a tip. I show you a little trick. May I borrow your newspaper? Thank you very much, you're a gentleman. I do a trick with the newspaper, you see. What you must do, you must remember something in this copy of the newspaper. Just remember the position of a headline or a photograph or an advertisement, something which you will know again in that copy of the newspaper. Are you doing that? Wasn't it fun? This trick is called the illusion of the torn newspaper. Now, it's called an illusion because I never, ever tear the newspaper. The idea of the trick is to make you think that I'm tearing the newspaper into lots and lots of little pieces, but I never tear it once. You know, people really do think they see me tear the newspaper. Isn't it stupid? Sometimes they even think they hear the sound of newspaper being torn, but it's all an illusion. It never, ever happens. And tonight, just for you, I'm going to show you how to do the trick. Aren't you lucky? What you do, you see, you take the edges of the newspaper and you squeeze them. And squeezing the edges of the newspaper, you weld them into place. So they become one newspaper again. I blow. I say the magic words. Olé. Torremolinos. And the newspaper is completely restored. Thank you. You see, there's the newspaper. There is that page of the newspaper. There is the middle page of the newspaper. There is that page. There's the front page. And that's worth 100% of you.
Soprendo.
How do you do?
Wonderful. Now listen, how did you do that?
Beautifully.
That's true. But listen, it was really incredible, that. And when we have people like yourself on the show, we always get people that write in and say, oh yeah, but that was so good, it must have been trickery, camera tricks. Do you get that?
No camera tricks at all. I get it a lot. It's just the magnetic hands and the spring steel fingers. There's nothing else. There's nothing else at all.
We believe you. It was marvellous. And what are you going to leave them as the clue?
Thank you very, very much. The clue is the tea bag. There is your tea bag.
And
the rhyme goes like this. The great Soprendo had some sport tricking the hotel guests. A fitting prize then this might be to match the other jests. Okay, you understand my English?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Very well said. And ladies and gentlemen, thank the great Soprendo.
Thank you.
What do you reckon, Pete? Any idea what that could be?
Jest could be a trick.
Uh-huh.
We haven't won you.
That, I mean, you're a comedian.
There
that's
you go,
jest.
You see. Well, that's open to conjecture, you know what I mean?
But
you thought the first one was something to do with, what?
Well, we thought, thinking about it, we thought it might have had something to do with towing a caravan or a boat.
And then Peter said homing pigeons, but I won't allow him to have another bird,
you
so... Wouldn't,
oh, well, that's fair enough. Right. Especially mummy-to-be and all that, you know what I mean?
Put it on the table.
No, don't let. Well, there's room. Now, listen, let's get on then and have our next item, because then we're going to have three on the table. You'll have to reject one. On our holidays abroad, we all like to sample the local life, whether it be the food, drink, or the arts. And in Spain, a must is their dancing. And we have a taste of that for you right now with Viva Flamenco. Viva Flamenco, this is Juan Ramirez. Juan Ramirez. Now, what are you going to leave, then?
Half of a castanet.
Just half of a castanet. Yes. I love all that. You do the guitar play, yes?
That's right.
And do you do any of that yourself?
Only when I've had a few drinks.
Only just then. Because I love those ones as well. It's like sending you a message, isn't it, that?
Well,
love all
I could
that.
Say that.
And you're leaving the half of the castanet, and what about the rhyme?
The rhyme says, castanets and artful heels ring out to the sound of guitars. Though you may be tempted to win this prize, we know it will still be ours.
Mm. Any idea, Hattie Joy?
Mm-hmm. It'll still be ours.
There you are.
Oh, I hope we haven't won a pair of those boots.
Well, there you are. Well, they're not bad boots, are they? But you're going to thank Juan Ramirez and Los Flamenco. No, Viva! Viva Flamenco! Yeah. Viva Flamenco. Well, OK, Juan has just read that one to you. I'm allowed to read you this one again, which was brought in by the great Soprendo, the tea bag, or, of course, Mike read you, Mike Newman read you the map that was left in the first scene.
Yeah, we'll have the tea bag.
You'd like to hear the tea bag?
Yeah.
OK, the great Soprendo. The great Soprendo had some sport tricking the hotel guests. A fitting prize, then, this might be to match the other jests.
Which one? What do you think about throwing the tea bag away, honey?
Okay. Right.
More like Barbara Streisand than she is, isn't
it? Oh, really? You
lovely.
Think so?
Yeah, beautiful. I like that. So you're going to reject the tea bag?
Yep. Why not?
Okay. Yep. All right, Peter? Yep. Fair enough. You're rejecting the tea bag brought in by the great Soprendo. Yes, okay. Yeah, bite your teeth. Let's see what it is. The great Soprendo had some sport tricking the hotel guests. Well, could we be going to send you to some major sporting event, maybe? A fitting prize than this might be. Any idea what that could be? Fitting? To make you think?
Suit.
Yeah, clothes, maybe.
Suits of some
possibly
sort.
Carpets or something like that to match the other jests, he said. Well, together with a tea bag, did that make you think we were playing a trick on you? I'm pretty sure, because we do get up to some little tricks on this show. Well, is there another sort of bag that you could put a tea into?
Ooh.
Ah. Oh, somebody said it
tea.
Behind me here.
Caddy?
Well, yes, caddy. It's pretty near.
Caddy?
If you spell T, yes, T-double-E, T's, golf T's, you've rejected a golf bag, but all this fabulous sporting equipment too. Look at this.
Oh, no.
Wow. There you go. Would you like to stand over there? Just stand over there and have a good look at this. Okay, there's just a little bit of sporting equipment here.
Oh, look.
We've got the exercise bicycle for you there.
I need that.
Oh,
yeah,
you
need
really
that, don't we
really
all? There's the rowing machine too. That's fabulous.
Wonderful.
Ever-increasing popular sport these days, of course, snooker. And, of course, golf. Do you play golf, Peter?
I don't, but I want to learn.
Well,
so
you could learn marvellously with this amount. Look at these clubs. Beautiful clubs here. Great trolley. Yeah. The umbrella as well. We've got indoor darts, again, becoming more popular every day. Indoor bowls. There's table tennis, hockey. And over the back there, we've got skis. Have you been on a skiing holiday?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you could have had those. Yeah. That would have come in handy. Just one set, but I'm sure somebody could have used them. They have been rejected. We had to go away for the break. See you back soon with Dusty Bin. Don't forget him. 3, 2, 1. See you in a moment. Welcome to part three, ladies and gentlemen. Well, Peter and Hedy Joy Babani from London have just rejected some fabulous sports equipment. However, we're going to press on with our theme of holidays abroad. Now, it's back for more fun in the sun, and this time we join the British tourist relaxing, having a massage after a hard day doing nothing. And he seems to be enjoying the treatment.
Oh, what holidays. Oh, eight blue skies, miles and miles of golden hands, God. Oh, and I think the wife wanted to go to Morecambe. I wish she had. Oh, oh.
This will really relax your muscles, monsieur.
Oh, just a bit lower, Marie, if you don't mind. Oh. Swivel plates. Oh.
This will really relax your muscles, monsieur.
God, I didn't even know the French knew that one. God. Oh, it's lovely.
You've got a beautiful back, monsieur.
Oh, well, you and I have a lot of common, Marias.
And such a strong chest muscles, too.
Well, it's the same thing, darling. You've got lovely, big, strong... I mean... Oh, God. Thank God the wife isn't here. Oh, Marie. Marie, I'll tell you what, Marie, my little darling, my little French little darling, your own flaming passions that have lain dormant and asleep for many years. Oh.
Really, Monsieur?
Oh. I think I may well lose control before this fortnight is over. Tell me, darling. I mean, what would you say if I was to pop up to your room tonight?
Well, put it like this, mon chéri. You go near anyone else's and you'll lose more than your control before this fortnight's over.
Oh.
Inflamed passions. I'll give you inflamed passions.
Oh.
You dirty...
Oliver! I've always loved you.
Rita, lovely to see you again, Rita. Great to have you back with us once again. And you're always a busy lady, aren't you? Going everywhere, doing all kinds of things.
Well, I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do next. You'll be rather surprised,
what's
Ted.
That?
I'm giving up acting, and I've become a dancer.
Oh.
I've joined Hot Gossip. And we're off to Las Vegas.
But it's great to have you with us. Listen, Rita, what are you going to leave Hetty, Joy and Peter here as the clue?
I'm leaving you these sunglasses.
Sunglasses are the clue, I see. And you have a rhyme for them, don't you?
Lying in the sun was fine, till our Rita came on the scene. Then his fun wasn't worth a tenner. But will you think that yours has been?
Hey, Eddie, what do you reckon?
Think mine has been. Tanner, sixpence.
Mm-hmm.
Six of the best.
Oh, well, good, we've got to think about it. Let's give Rita Webb a great thank you. Thanks, Rita.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Lovely to see you again.
Bye-bye,
lovey. Yeah. She's lovely, she really is. So I can read the castanet again, which was brought in by Juan.
Yes,
you'd like to hear that again?
Yes, please.
You'd like to hear the castanet?
Yeah.
Okay, Juan Ramirez of Viva Flamenco said, castanets and artful heels ring out to the sound of guitars. Though you may be tempted to win this prize, we know it will still be ours. That's
could
what
be the bin.
Got to reject that.
Could be the bin.
Well, you have three.
We'll reject the castanet.
Yes?
Yeah.
What my husband says.
He's the boss, is he?
Oh.
All right, Hetty Joy. I love that name, Hetty Joy.
There's my dad.
Another name for a hangover, isn't it? That? Hetty Joy. All right, let's see what it says. Oh. Castanets and artful heels ring out to the sound of guitars. Though you may be tempted to win this prize, we know it'll still be ours. Okay, castanets and artful heels ring out to the sound of guitars. Well, we've got Dusty, and he could be the artful heel. Castanets might have made you think of Spain, perhaps. A holiday, that's always there. Though you may be tempted to win this prize, we know it'll still be ours. Well, if you'd won a holiday, of course, that wouldn't be ours, would it? What about the castanet? Well, they usually come in pairs, and one is not much
use. No
good. That's
right. Put it in the bin.
So the only prize remaining, of course, it's not too much use. Absolutely right. Dusty Bin! Yeah! Okay, come around. Come along. Come along and meet this character. Super, huh? That's it. How do you do? But you're very, very happy about rejecting him, aren't
yes.
you?
Yes, great.
Yeah.
Absolutely,
absolutely
good. Well, there
yes.
he is, done up in a wonderful theme again of the holidays abroad. But you're very, very delighted you got him out the way. Our booby pie's been rejected. Take him away, Libby. We're going back to the table.
Right,
come on. Good. Here you are. Okay. Right, that means we know you're going home with a good prize. Whichever way you look at it tonight,
okay.
You've managed to get rid of the buoy, that's good. Our last Holidays Abroad excursion shows you what could happen if you don't select your hotel carefully. Now, you could get involved in the country's political scene, and that could be quite an experience.
Silence! 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 We'll all listen carefully. I will say this only once. What was I going to say?
Under Bundespan.
Oh, yes, and of course. You are all under a vest.
Aye? Nein.
Oh, arrest. Oh. Just my little joke.
It's a joke, Mamsie. Arrest a vest is a little joke.
I see English. Oh, English, you like the little joke, do you?
Yeah, that's
very
right, yeah.
Very good. You'll be very happy on this show then, I think. This is a takeover by the People's Army. One of the, maybe I'll tell the Fuhrer about this. Hmm? He likes to be in the swim. What is this here? Oh, damn sharks. They get everywhere. Right. Those of you who are undercover agents, take one step forward. The rest of you will be shot. Get back!
You leave my mom alone.
You are all my prisoners.
No! I don't want to be shot.
Get him off.
I plead.
Get off.
Oh, I leave.
Get off.
Please, let him go. He's innocent.
Innocent? Ha! In fact, ha! He's in it up to his neck.
What?
like a hotel paddling pool.
How can he be in a paddling pool up to his neck?
Because, my little English friend, he will be head down. Now then, I want to allocate some duties to you. First, the women. You will be sent to the hotel dining room.
Oh, no, no, we don't want to go there.
To work, not to eat. I am not that inhuman. And the men. We have some very interesting things planned for the men.
Hey, hang on, hang on. I've seen that film. Here, Mum, what's that prisoner of war film called?
Cold Tits.
That's it, Cold Tits. I've seen that film, and I insist that you treat us according to the rules of the Geneva Convention.
Listen, don't be getting smart with me, Sunlight. I know about the convention in Geneva. I've got a brother there. The thing is this. I received my training in one of the finest military establishments in the whole of England.
What, Sanders?
No! Butlin's Holiday Club! Here we
Robert Todd. Anyway, listen, what are you going to leave?
Well,
them,
what
Rob?
Am I going to do, Tim?
What's
I'm going to give
clue?
You this, first of all,
yeah.
Which is a 100 peseta note.
100 peseta note is the clue. Lovely.
And the
what
first
about,
one.
What about the rhyme? What's that
and
say?
The rhyme which I've been given here is...
Yeah?
Yeah, no, don't read it to yourself, Bob. Would you like...
Oh, I see, right.
Read it to Peter and Heavy George.
See. Sparring, which is a clue, though you may have a doubt, we wouldn't try to send you up if you throw this out.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bob. Well, I think we'll leave him there. It's better than the digs he's had this week. OK, you've just heard that from Bob. He's left you the 100 peseta note. I can read you the map again, which Mike Newman read you right at the top, or, of course, the sunglasses was brought in by Rita Webb. Which of these two would you like to hear?
Sunglasses.
Sunglasses.
Don't worry, he's tunnelling.
Is he a horror?
Yeah, you want to hear the sunglasses, yes? All right,
yes,
Rita said, lying in the sun was fun, till our Rita came on the scene, then his fun wasn't worth a tanner, but will you think yours has been?
Tanner.
Do you want to reject it?
I think so, yes.
Make up your own mind.
OK. Yep.
A gamble.
Yes, a gamble already. Now bins out the way. Dust is gone. So you want to reject?
The yes. Sunglasses.
The sunglasses from Rita.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's see what it says. Is Toddy still with us? Yes, or he's...
Oh, dear.
Well, I think we might need a machine in here pretty quickly, but he might enjoy that. Let's see what this says. Lying in the sun was fun till our Rita came on the scene. Well, could lying in the sun, with the sunglasses here, mean a holiday? Then his fun wasn't worth a tanner. You kept going on about tanner. Will you think yours has been? Well, does the prize mean it's not worth a tanner? Well, even a bin is worth a little bit more than that. But this... he's still down there. No, this prize is worth just a little bit more than a tanner. In fact, it is a tanner. Our eater is this eater. Heater, in fact... This is going to give you an all-round tan. It would have done if you'd have won it. This magnificent sunbed. Yeah, look at this. Go over there, Peter and Hedy. Just take a look at this. What do you say, Hedy?
You've got your tan.
Well, it's just like Aaron was saying earlier on, you can lie there for like half an hour or more, an hour. It just tans you nicely. Magnificent prize.
That's what... Oh.
Worth a lot of money. I'm sure you'd
if
like
I look
that.
Like that.
Yes.
Yeah, you would have liked that.
Would I come
you?
Out looking like that?
I'm pretty sure after a good game with that machine, it's a marvellous prize. It really is.
Gorgeous.
However, it has been rejected. We're going back to the table. Thank you, Karen. Take it away. Please. See, since we've been gone, Bob Todd's been struck. Oh, no, he's here. OK, we've got the final two here. Bob Todd left you this. It's a 100 peseta note. And Bob said, a health spa, in which is a clue, though you may have a doubt,
We wouldn't try to send you up if you throw this out. That's that one. As we have two, I can read them both again. And this was the very first one. This was read to you by Mike Newman, who said, keep this at home or toe the line. You may do one or the other, but as the rhyme unfolds, you may home in on another. So.
I think we should get rid of the 100%.
Oh, well, hey. I think...
Oh, that's good, Hedy. Yeah, you give him a hard time. You tell him what you think.
Hang about. I think that could be... I mean, health spa in Spain, spend the money...
We'll get rid of the 100%.
Mm-hmm. Oh, one of them has to go.
We'll throw it out. All right.
You will.
Quick, very quick.
You'll go along with Peter, OK? Right, you're going to throw away Bob Todd's 100% note. A health spa, he said, in which is a clue. Though you may have a doubt, we wouldn't try to send you up if you throw this out.
Send you up?
Hmm. Well, it's been rejected.
Mm-hmm.
There you are. It says a health spa in which is a clue, though you may have a doubt. There are quite a few health spas which might provide a clue. Now, how about bath spa, bath? Bathroom fittings, maybe? I know. We wouldn't try to send you up if you throw this out. Throw you out. You just latched onto that. Did that make you think of the bin? No, because you know he's gone. On the other hand, if you don't throw this out, presumably we would try to send you up. And the clue referred to was in the first line. It was in the line itself. It said, spa in. A spa in. Well, put them together. What have you got?
Spain.
Yes, yeah, Spain. You've rejected 2 weeks in Spain. That's what you've done. Look at this. Yes, look. Yes. Yes. Hello, Ross.
Oh,
yes. This is Roz. Hedy said, oh, look who it is.
Yes.
And everybody said the same.
She takes good care of us.
Yeah. Now, listen, they've rejected her 2 week holiday in Spain. Where would they have gone to, Roz?
Well, we were actually going
Take
to fly you to Marbella. Oh.
To Marbella.
That's right, to Marbella. And you were going to have a lovely 2 weeks. Marbella's in the Costa del Sol, as you probably know. And you were going to stay for 2 weeks in this luxurious hotel. And it stands in absolutely acres of gorgeous gardens. And in its grounds, it's got fantastic things like tennis courts and things like that.
Would have been nice. Would have been a nice break.
We'll talk about it later.
It's got a golf course, as you can
Look
see.
Look at that golf course.
Golf. And it also has stables and a riding school.
Ah, that would interest me.
Yes, you'd like that.
And, of course, it's got indoor and outdoor swimming pools.
Yes, look at that.
And, of course, fabulous beaches.
And paella.
2 whole weeks in sunny Marbella in Spain, huh? Lovely. The Spanish Riviera, it has been rejected. A marvellous prize, Hedy, I'm sure. A little upset about it now, aren't you? Mm. Yes,
well,
we
want to know what that is.
OK. Thank Ross, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks so much, Ross.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye. Take care. Thanks so much. Right, OK, this is the one we're left with, the map that was the number one item read out to you by Mike Newman, who said, keep this at home or toe the line. You may do one or the other, but as the rhyme unfolds, you may home in on another. Now, OK, the buzz is going through the audience. Keep this at home or toe the line. You may do one or the other. Keep this at home. Could that be a clue? Not a clue to the bin. Towing the line, well, is that something to do with dancing lessons? I don't think you need dancing lessons right now. Not you in your condition. But as the rhyme unfolds, you may home in on another. Well, the map would have unfolded as well. Is that any idea? Any idea about the map?
Showing us where to go.
Where to go, yeah. What would you use a map for travelling around? Well, you could have a lot more fun unfolding with this prize. And you're going to, yes. Mm-hmm. You're going to tow it wherever you like. It's a superb dual-purpose trailer. Take a look at your one. Here.
Oh.
Hang on, it's getting look at this. Oh, yeah, how's that? Come in! Come in! There you are.
That's unbelievable.
How's that, Hedy?
My baby.
Yes, you... Lovely. Hey, do you hear that, ladies and gentlemen? Hedy Joy has just said I could have my baby in there. Who knows? You might well do that. I think it's a marvellous prize, don't you?
Fantastic.
Hedy, you hadn't forgotten about your £900.
Oh,
have you, Peter?
No.
There's your £900 to
Fantastic.
Go with it.
Fantastic. Oh,
wonderful dual-purpose trailer. You have a car
That's
to tow
wonderful.
It with, I'm sure.
Ah.
Lovely. You're going to have a lot of fun with this, I'm sure you are. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a wonderful round of applause for Hedy Joy and Peter.
Thank you.
Thank Good
you
luck.
Very
Good luck, Peter. Smash it. Congratulations. Well, there you are, ladies and gentlemen. Once again,
lovely people going away with a great star prize. You want the prizes, we've got them on 3, 2, 1. See you next week. Good night, everyone. Have a good time. Here you go.
Thank you.